the end of the day, we all just want to do our job, the jobs that we've been doing for years, and we haven't done anything to deserve this. I mean, this is not about, it began about pay rise, it's not about pay rise anymore. This is our terms and conditions are absolutely, have been slashed, for the clerical anyway. Ours, our flexible working hours were taken off us from the 16th of January. Yeah. So that's gone for us. And it's just slowly by slowly, it's just become so disheartening for everybody involved. At the end of the day, the management in Bus Éireann don't want us standing out here. We don't want to be standing out here. The public don't want us out here. They want to get to work. They have things to be doing as well as anyone else. Yeah. So we need somebody to intervene.
Mm-hmm. Well, what prompted us to come here today is the letter that was issued on the 22nd of March by the management of Bus Éireann, which were cutting 46 terms and conditions that we built up over many years, and we're not going to give them up. And we're not going to take a pay reduction. We've gone 10 years without a pay rise. We've shown great restraint in those 10 years, and we were told at the time that if we showed this restraint, that we would be rewarded when the economy turned. The economy has turned, but we're now being punished.
It's very, very upsetting, you know. And you might see that the camaraderie here, but we're all united on this. We all are a front for this. And it's going to be whatever it takes, we're going to do it. Like, they're going to be taking the filth from our children's mouths, you know? So none of us are going to let this happen.
As trade unionists, it's an attack. This is an attack on what we stand for and what we believe in. And if we believe in the social conscience, which we seem to be with homelessness and others other issues with the hospitals, very serious issues, this might pale into what's happening out there with some people's lives. But the implications for us, and this is how serious it is, that Bus Éireann could go down. Mm. We don't want that. We don't want to be here. We'd rather be inside working.
We received these letters come January. We were affected with our flexible hours, and it's letter after letter, and we just feel enough is enough. We kind of have to take action. We just really need the government to intervene now, just in relation to this, because it's just gone on way too long.